In a world where hope is lost, in a world where devastation occurs every day, two men are called upon to rise up and heal the world. They are known by only two names, MickeyD. On DiceFM. Join the show.
Hey guys, welcome to MickeyD and the Butcha Boys, Awkward Halfva on DiceFM. We are right here. We are right now, aren't we, Butcha Boy? How are you?
I'm good, thank you, young man. How about yourself?
Thank you for calling me young. I feel youthful after that statement.
You do look very youthful, right? I have to say.
Thank you. You're looking splentastical as well.
Thank you.
Look at those tracky dacks.
Yeah, rolling them up,
rolling them up. That just, those trackies equal hitman.
So we are rule.
You know what the words on the street is? Jimbo.
Jimbo. They want him back.
They want him back. It's unbelievable the feedback we've had.
It is.
I've had people just running up to me.
Yeah, nearly bowling you over.
Did you get that?
I get the same thing as well, yeah.
They're going, Jimbo, where is he?
Where is he? Bring him back.
Bring him back.
Bring him back.
Now. So to all the listeners out there, we will bring him back.
Oh, it's gonna happen.
Shortly.
It's gonna happen.
And we've got some ideas.
Oh, we're gonna he doesn't know yet.
We're gonna throw something at him.
Oh yeah. It's gonna be heavy.
And he doesn't know what's coming. It's gonna be really exciting, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm excited.
Alright, let's kick to a song like we usually do. Try not to get too distracted there, Butcha Boys. He's watching girls in lingerie on the telly.
Zoo ad.
Pretty good ad as well.
It was.
Let's move on. I want you to go to the song, but first I want you to give the listeners a reason why the song is about the song. That doesn't make any sense at all, does it? Pick a song.
You could have given me a little warning here. And,
no, pick a song and then...
So what have we done last week? And
let's not even try and remember what we played last week. Just pick a song and just tell the listeners what it's about. What does it mean?
Oh, we'll go Bright Lights.
All right. What title track. Title track off our album.
Which pretty much sums up us and me trying to make it in music.
Yep.
And I'm pretty lost most of the time. Let's be honest. And it's pretty much about being drunk and walking the streets thinking, what am I doing here? I want to be somewhere else. Yeah.
You want to be where the bright lights are, which
the bright lights
resemble being on stage. Yep.
Yep.
Well, this is Bright Lights, everyone. This is MickeyD and the Butcha Boy on the Awkward Halfva. Enjoy.
When I'm drunk, when I'm all alone, wanna feel something real, something beautiful, something new, something truly incredible, but I can't find her. Maybe I look in all the wrong places, might explain all the strange looking faces, put my nose to my toes to find traces, but I can't find her. So good, so touching wood.
Bang!
Bang!
That was impressive.
Was aggressive.
That was aggressive, and I like the debate with that because it's an aggressive topic.
Yeah, it is.
This
it
debate,
is.
Isn't it?
It is.
So, welcome back, guys. That was Bright Lights before on DiceFM. MickeyD and the Butcha Boy. Debate of the week. What is it, Butcha Boy?
Debate of the week this week is Cubicle
versus.
What's that thing you urinate on? Urinal.
Urinal. That's right.
Yes.
Just adjusting the microphone. Right.
Call it whatever you want, pal.
Yes.
Well, that's the debate, isn't it?
Yeah. So,
what are you going to choose? This is really for men, isn't it? Because women don't have urinals.
Yeah. But I reckon I'd be excited by this topic because they don't understand.
Really? Oh, okay.
They don't understand. So, they want to get our male's perspective.
But we're a bit weird, aren't we?
We are. So, I mean, with us... It's not really a debate, is it? Pretty crystal clear.
Cubicle. We go for the wait. The awkward wait. Everyone's going, what are they doing?
Yep.
They're not waiting. You know, the line sort of... Because it's not a clear line.
No.
You're in the middle. You're looking... You're sort of... You're facing the cubicle.
Yep.
But there's a clear spot free for you.
Yep.
In the urinal. But you're not taking it.
Yeah, I'm not taking it.
Yeah.
I'm not taking it at all.
The pressure is quite immense.
I've had some moments in my time where I've... gone the urinal.
Yeah.
And or
how about let's go to McDonald's in a little town called Horsham.
Do we have to bring that up?
Yes, I think we do. It's very appropriate.
All right, so we're driving back from Adelaide. It's you, me, the Babs, and the Susatron,
wasn't I?
Yes, Susatron. That was after the Adelaide holiday, which was good. It was fun, wasn't it?
New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
Yep. Went off.
We went to bed.
You guys in bed at like
12:05.
Is it done yet? All right.
Yeah, done. Cool. Yeah. All right. No, it was hot. It was hot though as well. Temperature wise.
Yeah.
So we got to Horsham, and I really needed to go to the toilet. So it was a packed Macca's, wasn't it? It was the busiest Macca's I've ever seen. Walk in, going straight to the toilet, went to the toilet thinking, yep, there'll be at least one urinal, at least one cubicle.
It's not going to be that busy.
Not going to be that busy.
Come on. It's a toilet in Macca's. Yeah, it's not going to be that busy.
I walk in. There's one urinal. There's an out of order sign on the cubicle. There's about 10 dudes lining up. I'm thinking, oh my God.
And you can't just do the walkout.
I can't do the walkout because by the time I realized, oh my God, there was already three guys behind me.
Yeah.
So I'm like, all right, I'm in the queue. I'm going to have to do this. I'm going to have to.
The whole way through.
The whole time I'm waiting going, you're going to have to relax. You're going to have to really relax and let the stream flow. It's my time to shine. I get up to the plate and there's about 10 dudes behind me waiting, right?
Yeah.
My time to shine. I'm frozen.
Yeah.
Nothing. Frozen solid. I'm frozen solid. There's nothing coming.
Just sweat dripping down.
The only thing that's dripping is sweat. Yeah. And I'm thinking, what do I do? Do I fake? Can I fake it?
Just spit a lot or something.
And I'm thinking, I can't even fake it because they're that close to me. Like, the dude behind me would be half a foot.
Yeah.
It's very close. I can't even fake it.
Were you pushing a lot trying to get it out?
Oh, it was.
Because you let one rip, maybe. That would have been amazing.
I reckon, yeah. I reckon a shit would have come before
it. You just shit yourself and there's nothing.
And so I'm standing there for a good 30 seconds. Nothing's coming, knowing 10 dudes are going, what the hell's going on with this guy?
There's no stream.
I'm not hearing a stream.
He's sweating.
He's got some.
He's still in the shakes.
He's looking a bit shaky. Is he drunk?
Yeah.
Is he drunk? But nothing's coming. And then I decide, this is not going to happen. I'm going to have to make the awkward walk away.
Yep.
So I did the turnaround, acting like I'd done it.
Yep.
And 10 dudes looking at me going,
you did not do that. Did you do the wash hands? And?
Yeah, I did the wash hands. No, actually, I didn't. I got the hell out of there.
Okay.
Once I turned around and they all looked and I knew that they knew.
You just knew.
I got the hell out of there. And I went straight to the car. I didn't even, you guys were ordering food. I went straight to the car and then I really need to go. Red Rooster was across the road. I considered racing over there. I didn't. But I ended up, we ended up pulling over somewhere. I don't know. But
yeah, I can't remember.
That was one of the worst That's highlights.
That's amazing. That is amazing.
Yeah. There was also another time in Mildura.
Really?
Outside a nightclub.
Yeah.
And I'd been busting because we got a taxi to the club and it was about it's 20 minute drive and I was busting.
Yeah.
Another guy was busting as well. No, two guys. So we go to the wall just outside the club, behind the club. There's a 6'8" guy next to me and a 6'9" guy next to me. And I really need to go. Their streams are flowing.
No worries.
There's no hesitation. Hey, there's no hesitation. And they're about 6'8" by 6'8" as well.
Little piggy in the middle.
And I'm the biggie in the middle. And I'm struggling.
Yep.
So I'm thinking to myself, do I say anything? And I thought, yep. And I turned to them and I go, fellas, I'm having a little bit of trouble. And they're like, what's wrong? Come on, get it together. You'll be all right. I go, no, stage fright. And so I nearly wet myself. I raced into the club, straight to the urinal. I'm straight to the cubicle. And it was fine.
Bang.
But that's me. I have to go
cubicle.
I find
the pressure too much.
It's insane, isn't
Sometimes,
it?
Sometimes, if you have a lot,
you can do it?
You can do it.
It's not like being in kindergarten where you can drop your dacks to your ankles.
I had a guy, yeah. In primary school, he'd do that.
My
Indian friend. He'd walk in and go, what was his name? Mohan. Mohan. Jack, trackies, no shame. Down around the ankles, that's it. Just wouldn't, not the knees, all the way down. You're down. And he'd be just...
So just full ass.
Full legs, everything. Like it was down there, you could have taken them off. You wouldn't have.
Did you ever say anything to him?
Well, it's a bit awkward. I don't know, you're young and.
Yeah, I guess you're not going to go. Hey,
that's
buddy.
That's just it.
Just confident.
He's confident,
babe. Imagine doing that nowadays. Imagine going to a club, pants down the ankles.
That would be amazing.
You would have to have some serious drinks in you to do that.
What?
You don't like it? You don't like it? Turn the other way, buddy.
Imagine the old pulling them back up again.
What about at the pool room with the blind guy? you got to tell the viewers this story.
That was funny. We're going in there. I walk into the urinal.
Yep.
I was pretty drunk as well, but so I was waiting for the urinal. So I'm going to stuff it.
Okay. So you must be drunk.
I don't care where the gap's going to be. I'm going to jump in there and I'm going to release. But before that, a young man that was actually blind walked in to go to the toilet with his cane, which is not funny. But he was drunk.
It's not funny as you laugh.
Yeah. He had his cane and he's walking up trying to... he's walked up to this guy. He's one of the toughest guys you'd probably see. And he thinks he's pretty bloody cool as well, you know.
Pretty
he's,
tough.
He's peeing away on the in the urinal. On the urinal. And then the blind man walks up and he's just tapping away, tapping, tap, tap, tap. And then he thinks he's found the urinal, which is...
he's found the
which
spot.
Which is the tough guy's leg. So he's going tap, tap. And then he's zipped down and started pissing. Because the guy didn't know what he was doing until he started pissing on his leg. And so then he went nuts. But he couldn't go that nuts because the guy was blind.
Yeah.
So he didn't know what the fuck
so
was going
on. So what did he do?
So he just standing there pissing and he's trying to pee. Yeah.
Did he end up grabbing the guy's
shoulders?
Other
guys had to help him out.
Yeah.
Help him and just finish the job. Yeah, the guy, I'm guessing, had to go home because he had piss all down his leg.
Oh, that would have been nasty.
Which is quite funny.
Imagine having a great night out and then just getting pissed.
Yeah, pissed on.
Pissed on, yeah.
Like Luke, my mate Luke, waiting for the urinal. The queue was nearly out the door. He's gone, oh, I can't wait anymore. Bang, sink. He's just looking at the guy's gone, sorry. He's pissing in the sink.
No,
he's
shame.
The other way. He would love to get out. This doesn't matter. Any occasion.
Any occasion. Plant, tree,
yep.
Sidewalk, out. If it needs to go.
He doesn't even need to go.
He just wants it out.
He wants it out.
He wants it to set
it
free.
He wants it shown and known.
Yeah, see, yeah. So this debate's pretty clear, isn't it, for us? It's cubicle.
Or nothing.
Or nothing. And that's just the way we roll. I'm sure there's dudes that love to be in the stalls.
Like the footy boys.
Love to get it out.
Just gear off. Bang.
Let's have a look, fellas. Let's line them up and see what we're playing
with. This is what I got.
Not me.
No. It's your thing.
It's private. It's the only...
your wang. Keep it your wang and all.
Yep. Only for... Yep. Me and... whoever...
Where are we going?
Let's go to a song. This is MickeyD and the Butcha Boy on DiceFM. And are we going to It's All About You? Yes, we are. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Now.
That was amazing.
The chords were wrong, but
that's
all right.
Wrong. I dropped the pick.
And you dropped the pick as well. All right, this is It's All About You. Yeah. Hey guys, welcome back to Mickey D and the Butcha Boys, Awkward Halfva on
DiceFM.
That was It's All About You and a bit of me.
And a little bit of everyone.
Yeah, that's right. So, what are we talking about? We're talking about Friday night because Friday night's
big gig.
Yes, and it's not just the gig, it's a gig forever. Not forever, but it's
a couple of weeks.
Dice, this is huge news for the Dice fanaroos out there.
All of you.
We have a residency. Yes, that's right.
Bang, Friday nights.
Friday nights at
Port Melbourne
Pony Club.
But just letting all the paparazzi know there's no paparazzi. So
allowed, yes.
They're not allowed in the building.
There's a big sign out the front with two security guards next to us saying, don't even think about...
Not cameras.
So remember that all the media outlets, especially The Age. I'm sick of that guy.
Yeah, I know. Just guys and girls.
Mostly. Right. It's mostly guys with them.
Yeah, it wasn't it?
I don't know. I just want to pick up some corn and some potatoes, and he's just following me into the Safeway.
I want a meal, mate. Calm down.
I'm just over it. But anyway, so we've got a residency at the Pony Club. our good mate, Christopher Needham, is head chef there, and he can cook some chips.
He can, and some parma. That was a mean parma.
That was a big and mean parma.
And it was good,
parma.
Quality. Yep. Quality and big.
Yep. So
they're hard to find, those... That duet right there.
It's true.
It's hard to find.
It's a good point. Usually you get big but not quality, or you get little and good quality.
That's what I like to think anyway.
That's like what we all want to think. And just a segue from the debate, the toilets there, two cubicles.
Fantastic. Oh, hang on.
Two cubicles. And then also upstairs, two cubicles. So I'm really excited about that as well.
There's no pressure.
No pressure at all. Oh, the stream was flowing without hesitation, wasn't it? Yep. So we had three sets of 40 minutes.
Yep.
So pretty much 24 songs, and we played five covers. We played Shimmer. We played Snow Patrol. We played Freak.
What else do we play?
You Somebody.
Not the wrong tuning.
Oh, okay.
No, it's not happening.
You Somebody, and we also played Time of Your Life, which is exactly like that. And if you had to give us a ranking or a rating out of 10, what would you give us, Butcher Boy? First up gig.
First gig, I think we
had 2 days
for
notice.
The covers.
Yep.
Was about a 3.5.
Out of five. Yep. So a 7 out of 10.
Yeah.
And then overall?
The whole night, I reckon 7.
Yep.
To what we could be.
To what we could be, yeah.
Yes.
Look, the problem as well is it's hard to perform at your peak when you're playing to your mum and dad.
Yeah.
And that's it,
Chris.
Really.
And they're watching the telly that's above us.
Yeah, I knew that would be an issue. I mean, I like the setup, but having the telly right above your head is a little bit of an issue, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So the whole reason is this place is pumping on Sundays, isn't it?
It's crazy.
But every other night, it's not. No. It's a really nice place.
It's awesome.
Spacious.
Looks really cool.
Really cool. Old school, but new school as well.
Yeah.
So they want live music, and they want to get it pumping on the Friday, and they've asked us, obviously,
to come down. What we're doing,
so it's really exciting because it's unusual for a pub to want original music to be played.
Yep.
And so we're this huge opportunity for Dice and the Dice fans out there. So if you
come down, have a meal. There's no tickets or anything. It's free.
It's free. You know, come down, have a meal. Say hi, and we'll play some tunes.
We've got three sets, so just come down for one set or whatever. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, we're pretty much 7 till 10, aren't we?
We are.
So it was a really good night, and hopefully it will pick up over the next month or so.
Yeah, get some more people down.
But we'll keep you posted anyway. So yeah. So next song. I think next song.
Can we? Have we got it? Would we even want to go there?
Oh, look, we've got an old back catalogue of songs, don't we? And this
will be the first right back.
Can you just play this riff? Again. So this song here, folks. this is...
Make everything sound so easy. Make everything sound so clear.
I was going to tell the listeners that that song is very special to us.
Oh, it is.
Because that is the first song we ever wrote.
First 5 minutes.
It was pretty much, it was you, me, and at the time, Chicken was in the band
he
as well.
He didn't arrive yet.
And he hadn't arrived. He was running late. And so you came in, and in 5 minutes, we came up with it. It's called Late Again because it's about
me. Being late again, which I am extremely good at.
You're extremely good at it, but it was also a special being late. You were late to your dad's...
Wedding. Third wedding.
Third wedding. Oh, it doesn't matter then. Third wedding.
Come on.
But, yeah, I'll track it down in the back catalogue and we'll play it maybe.
Just remember, bear with us, it was right at the start.
Right at the start.
We were young lads.
First ever song, we're just learning as a band how to play songs and what to do, but... It's still pretty good.
Yeah.
Had some chimes in there, actually.
It did.
Yeah. So we're not going to play that, but we will...
What?
I'll track it down and we'll play it next week.
Next week?
Yeah.
So that whole segue is just gone.
Well...
That whole...
Well,
all right, so it's going to... All right, so what are we going to play now?
It'll take me a little while. Yeah.
What should we play now?
Well, I think we should play... Dream. I love that. Yeah. You were thinking that?
Yeah.
Okay. This Dream Called Life on DiceFM. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
Raise the curtains, break the shadows. Let us live this dream called life. With no orders and no borders. Free as angels, we will roam. I'll have your back and you'll have mine. What if matter, 'cause we'll be fine. The sinners will turn to saints. The streets will be safe tonight. To a stranger,
than a smile to your foe, even though you don't want to. Put your ear to the ground, can you hear what I'm hearing? Like a colliding to create thunder.
Guys, that was This Dream Called Life on DiceFM with the Inner Butcha Boys, Awkward Halfva. What a show, Butcha Boy. Good show.
It's been fantastic and riveting.
The debate was strong.
It was a strong one today.
It was a very strong one. Any feedback, please let us know on YouTube. Comments coming aplenty. We've had quite a few.
Just look it up there.
Cheerio to...
If I don't get back to you, you know, it's because we got so many coming through.
Well, that's why I wanted to give a cheerio to the Babichon, because every week we're getting comments from her. So
much love.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it. Keep them coming. We're going to finish the way we always finish, and that is a word from my mate, not your mate, Russell Crowe.
He's a prick. Sorry, just had to throw it in there. Right?
That was really aggressive. Look, he's doing us a favour. He is Russell Crowe, remember?
He's doing you a favour, right?
All right, he's doing me a favour.
That's right.
All right, so thanks for listening,
thanks, guys.
And this is Russ singing...
Signing off,
Dice FM.
Yeah.
See you guys.
Bye.
G'day, guys. This is Russell Crowe. I just farted. Deal with it. Anyway... You probably know me from such movies as Hello Confidential or the big star in Cinderella Man. Even though it sounds pretty gay, it was not. Let me tell you that right now. Right, so I've heard the subject today is whether to go the cubicle or the urinal. Let me go through what I think would be the appropriate approach. What I like to do is walk in, find the biggest bloke at the urinal. I don't care if there's a gap or not a gap. I'm going to stand right there next to him. Then what you're going to do is unzip and slap the gear on the palm. Look to the big bloke next to you. Give him a knowing wink. That's all right, mate. I'm Russell Crowe.